Great discussion there, and thank you so much for joining us, and welcome back from the break. My name is Simon Otela. We're still here at the Sheraton Kampala Hotel. Let's now take a look at the next story. And NSSF, good news for the savers. Yes, those of you that did get the results, good stuff for you there. And of course, also, you can now only wait for the interest. Also, there was a report that was released that indicated almost 106.2 trillion shillings coming through in 1.6 trillion shillings that came through in the financial year 17-18, which is a good stuff for the savers with the fund. Of course, the directors there did say it, despite the tough investment opportunities in the country and economic ups and downs, there was still a platform for them to make some money that they will be able to pay you as the savers with the fund. Take a look.
The National Social Security Fund will pay its members an interest rate of 15% for the financial year 2017-2018, a figure higher than what was paid in 2016-2017. This is on the back of a good performance that saw the earnings grow by 26% from 7.9 trillion shillings in 2017 to 9.9 trillion in 2018. NSSF, according to the results recently released for the first time, hit 1.6 trillion shillings in revenue, up from 912 billion shillings posted last year. The new interest rate means that for every 1 million shillings a member has with the fund, he or she will receive 150,000 shillings extra on his or her account.
A significant improvement on whatever balances they were having with us. If you go in a commercial bank, they might give you 3, 4, 5%. But NSSF is giving 15%, a very big return. If you compare with the investing with Bank of Uganda, Treasury Bill, it has been about 9%. And now levies might be slightly higher than that. But 15% is certainly a significant return to members. And for those who are getting their money this year, they are getting it in cash. For those who are saving still ahead, to be at 55, no problem. And if you reach 50 years and you have no employment, you can also still get that money.
It represents a significant step in our economic growth, especially that savings culture has improved substantially, and we have now over 10 trillion in assets. That is a significant step in the right direction as far as savings is concerned. What it means also is that that money is available for investments in Uganda and also in the South African region, subject to, of course, amendments to the Act, UBRA, which will allow them to globally. So it really represents a very significant step for us as a country, and I want to reiterate what I said earlier, and that is to thank the chairman of the board of directors, the management and the staff for a job well done this financial year.
It also means that members of the fund will earn 1.1 trillion shillings this year, and it is in line with the fund's commitment to pay a competitive return to its members. The fund currently has about 2.2 million registered members, but the fund is looking at ways of increasing membership, but lies a number of challenges. Here is a graphical breakdown of the fund's performance. The assets under management increased by 26% from Uganda shillings 7.92 trillion in 2017 to Uganda shillings 9.98 trillion in 2018. Total income increased by 77% to Uganda shillings 1.6 trillion in 2018 from Uganda shillings 912 billion in 2017. Member contribution grew by 14% to Uganda shillings 1.05 trillion in 2018 from Uganda shillings 917 billion in 2017. Benefits paid out to qualifying members increased by 29% to Uganda shillings 360 billion in 2018 from Uganda shillings 278 billion in 2017. Compliance levels rose to 81% in 2018 from 80% in 2017, leading to improved contributions. Cost of administration stayed flat at about 12.3%. Cost to income ratio declined by 1% to 12.6% in 2018. From 13.4% in 2017.
Initially, we had confidence problems, especially when there were issues to management. But I think that has largely been sorted out. Now people now have the confidence to be able to invest that. As you can see, in less than 3 years, the number of members has gone up from 500 million to 2.2 million.
When we are investing, We have got through the minister, we have got through the solicitor general. It is a very long process, and the investment is a very short-term business activity. They want you to respond in the next 1 or 2 days. But here, the process can take 6 months, can take 1 year. By the time it is through, the investment is lost, and we cannot participate and be competent. We cannot compete under those levels.
National Social Security Fund paid out 360 billion shillings as benefits to members in 2017-18 financial year, a 29% increase from 278 billion shillings paid out in the same period last year. This was mainly attributed to growth in interest income and regional equity markets, with its fixed income assets at 75%, equity at 18.09% and real estate at 6.53%.
Great stuff there. In time now, take a look at what's happening in the personal finance tips for this week. And we are talking what an investment club should be. An investment club must have a dream and also must have a goal. And the members must understand that they're not getting together because they're probably friends. Now, this is one thing I've noticed, because sometimes guys are out having a good time and then, you know, you think about an idea and you take it up. So when the idea starts, you do not think about the principles of having that thing successfully run. Let me break it down for you. You're out probably with the boys and you decide and say, you know what, guys, why don't we be saving some money every month? Good stuff, great idea. So you're going to pick the chairman of the club. You're going to pick how many people you want. You have the treasurer, the secretary, and then you have the first meeting and you start pooling funds. Good stuff. The challenge now comes in when you fail to apply the principles of a successful investment club. And some of these successful investment clubs will have principles such as, you need to know the number, which you probably have. You need to take records of whatever your investment you want, you have. The dreams that you're setting is now what is not clear. You're probably thinking, okay, we are pulling about 200 bucks every month. All you have is when you get the money, you give it out and I decide what I want to do with the money. This is the idea. How about when you pull that money, we have an investment that we both all want to do as a team. Let's say when we pull 200K per month and we decide once we are 10, it's 20 million or so. Let's put that money into this project. So that project will be making money for the club. Because every time you have an investment club and all you do is take money out and you do what you want, sometimes you might take the money as an individual and you might not actually invest it. So it's important for you to have a dream as an investment club and also have a goal. At the end of the day, what do you want to achieve as a group? Just take a look at that and see if your investment club is probably doing the right thing or there are a couple of things that you need to change moving forward. That should be for personal finance tips for this week. Thanks for watching. Right, good stuff there. Thank you so much for making time this weekend, catching your best business show in town. With me, Simon Oktela, down here at the Sheraton Kampala Hotel. Back again next week, we'll be talking oil and gas sector and training for SMEs. Can they have a full play in the oil and gas industry ahead of the 2020 oil production? Until then, you take care of yourselves. Make money, invest. We'll see you soon.